Does the full police cam video exonerate the officer in Atlanta? Will every Confederate statue soon be replaced with monuments of Dolly Parton? And if your business does not have a special section for black people, are they racist? These questions and so much more will get answered today on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
This is Coach Chestnut at the Joe Padula Show. What I like most about Joe is get an opportunity to talk and share our stories here in Clarksville. Absolutely.
Ooh-wee. Monday. Monday. It is Monday. And yes, welcome to Clarksville's Party with Purpose, the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely. Woo! Ah, yeah. It is Monday, June 15th, this our Lord's year, 2020. And this combat war veteran, formerly with the 2nd Brigade Combat Team Strike, 101st Airborne Division, Air Assault, is ready. I am ready for some real talk. I am ready for some real facts. I am ready for your real opinions, and I'm ready to party with a purpose. Absolutely. Thanks for hanging out with us. Thanks for joining the show. Season 9, episode 8. Unbelievable. Show's divided into two parts. National, local. Simple. Too easy. Too easy, as we used to say in the Army. That's right. It was an honor to serve this great nation in uniform, and now I try to do the best I can out of uniform. Naked. I am a nudist. I don't know if you need to know this. Shelly, did you know that? I'm a nudist.
You're not.
I am a nudist at heart.
Oh, at heart.
Mm-hmm. Like, not in public, but like at home, I'm a nudist.
I think actual nudists would complain about you claiming to be a nudist.
Why is that?
Because you're not one.
I walk around the house naked at times. Ugh. Right?
Who don't?
That, thank you. Bay, nudist bay, everybody.
Everybody at heart.
Lawyer Wayne, you can't because you have 9 kids.
No, I'm never a nudist at home. Only in my professional life.
Okay, only at work.
Only at heart.
I'm not even wearing pants right now.
Oh, my God.
That's why they have the camera and the table. I'm a partial nudist.
I once caught a fish this big.
I'm gonna keep my hand right here.
Both your hands, please.
Unbelievable. But yeah, hey, you the audience. We got a lot to go over here, not a lot of time. So, hey, write in your comments. You got questions or anything, type them in. They pop up on the screen. Test it out. Say, hey, how you doing? All right, and we'll get to them as best as we can. We got Shelly on the social media. You're going to be keeping tabs, right, Shelly?
Yes, I am.
All right, good, good. And hey, if you don't catch this show live and you need to hear it or the entire episode, we're picked up by Our Heart Radio, TuneIn, Spotify, Apple Podcast, Google Podcast. The shows are being uploaded to YouTube also, so if you don't want to get back, either go back to the Facebook page. But hey, definitely click like and share. Start sharing it now. Woo! Click those share buttons. We need the help. Spread the word. Let's keep real, effective conversation alive, my friends. I'm excited to be here. Well, I asked the question. If your business does not have a special section for black people, are they racist? It's a crazy weekend. Crazy weekend. So last week, it was last Tuesday on the show. Okay, we had Casey Bryant of Local Clarksville in the studio hanging out with us.
Okay.
She actually just got back from a run. So if you go back to the show, you can see her. She's all sweaty.
Right.
She's all sweaty in her running clothes. But Local Clarksville, which is this, it's a promotional site here in town that highlights businesses, their owners, their venue, and events that are happening in Clarksville, Tennessee, the Queen City.
Right.
You know, good. They do a very good job at it. Very professional approach at it. It's good camera work, and I dig them. Well, last Tuesday, so Casey came on, and she was talking about how she was getting inundated with these messages.
Eric said the door is locked.
Eric?
Yeah.
Oh, Eric's downstairs?
Yeah. He said the door is locked.
Eric! Thank you for that, bang. Let me tell him, use the side door. Use the side door. Use the side door.
We have a special bat entrance.
Where we are parked. Where we are parked. Come on. And yes, we are broadcasting live from the Office Now studios. Hey, you made it, Eric! Ladies and gentlemen, Eric Torres! Here, have a seat next to Shelly, Eric. Have a seat next to Shelly, all right? Woo! Yeah, I should have told. Oh, isn't the place look great, Ryan? The brand new studios. And yeah, throw those headphones on and the microphone.
Right. Get close to the microphone, make a little up.
Oh, it looks good. You look good, Eric. Yeah. How are you, brother?
Tired.
Yeah, you're tired? Well, Eric, what do you do for a living?
Child protection.
Child protection. Oh, I bet you got crazy stories, right?
Yeah, I cannot confirm which state, but you know.
Yeah, no, I hear you, brother. I hear you. But I was just explaining, local Clarksville here in town, it's a promotional site, promotes businesses, the owners, events and everything going on here. Well, last week, Casey Bryan of local Clarksville came on the show and she was telling us how she was getting inundated with the messages saying that they want to see a separate feature on black-owned businesses, okay? So here, let me tell you, I got some of these, let me pull up some of the messages here. All right, hold on, Seven Nation Army. I need you to take a break for a second. Okay. Whew. All right, here we go. Let's see. That's funny that Bay saw the message from Eric.
Yeah.
That was good.
Let me in.
Let me in.
Torture lock.
All right, here, let's do this. I'll read these messages to you. You can see them on the screen also. All right, here we go. Let's take a look. All right, here's one of them. All right, this is from the local Clarksville page, and Ashley Baird, okay? She wrote, I would love to see a feature of the amazing black-owned businesses in our town, okay? And then you got this Macy Riley. Yes, I agree, Ashley Baird. Kayla Sheehan, I agree with Ashley. We need to see local organizations uplifting everyone in the community, and to do that, you need to feature them like you do other businesses, groups. I scroll through your feed and would love to see more diversity. All right, and then let's see if we got their response. So here's what local Clarksville put out for a response. Welcome to our community. I'm a proud, this is from Tara of local Clarksville, mm-hmm. Not Casey. This was Tara, as you see your name on the
still
bottom there.
Still speaking for both.
Yeah, still for it, right. So she goes, born and raised Clarksvillian, so I'm excited you found our lovely little town. Well, it's actually a big city, Tara, but whatever. Okay. We do not have any plans to highlight, separate businesses based on race or gender. We are part of a very tight community and created a forum and outlet that encompasses all of our amazing small business owners, artisans, and farmers without bias. The very nature of our message is to connect as a community. Race is not a factor for us as we live out our mission, bring everyone together in a positive, uplifting way. Right. Having said that, we do highlight the veteran-owned businesses. The military is such an integral part of the Clarksville community in one of the most intertwined ways, okay? Hey, I like this reply so far, you know, but we have a great relationship with our Hispanic owners in our community as well as a multitude of other nationalities. We'd then have to separate everyone in so many categories. It would not look like the model and mission we've created. We respect your feedback. So then, okay, so that's the message. All right, let's just go over that message real quick. Okay, so we just put the message out there that they replied with. Lawyer Wayne, your first thoughts.
It sounds like somebody's saying, I'd like to see, if I understood right, they were saying, I want to see more black businesses highlighted, or I wanted a black-only section.
Uh-huh.
I don't know.
Right.
But their reply was, look, we just highlight all the businesses. We don't discriminate based on or categorize based on race and gender. There are places that do. You know, I can imagine someone opening up, you know, women's businesses of Clarksville where they, you know, only highlight women. Or
right.
Doing like a blacks-only promotion. I suppose people would like that. Feels a little iffy to me, but I don't know.
See, it's weird because, Bay, we've been doing this show for quite a few years now.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? And our mission is to also highlight businesses and events and what's going on. We're kind of the same media. We're just different platforms, yeah. Local Clarksville and I, right?
Mm-hmm.
And would it be weird if I had, all right, ladies and gentlemen, here's our black guest for the week.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Like segregation.
Right.
Yeah.
Because your problem
so
with that
I can't
is,
do that.
Your worry is, why are you highlighting that fact about them, right?
Mm-hmm.
I can understand the veteran-owned business, you know, okay, they're a special class of people, veterans, and people like to support veterans in particular.
But that's not a race.
Right. It's just...
It's not a race. That's a good point, Shelley.
It's a background of military service. It would be tough to do something like that in the context of an online business promotion without, as she says, you're going to get complaints from, you know, you can imagine getting complaints from somebody else and say, well, I got this special characteristic. I'm, you know, Asian or Jewish or something. I want my own special section as well.
Right.
Now, Eric, in that reply message, there was the mention of the Hispanic community.
Right.
Was that part needed in the message?
Here's the thing, Joe, on the whole thing.
Yeah.
I'll say it like this. The court of public opinion has no statute of limitations.
Okay.
And we've all seen that lately. You know, eventually it's going to come around to everybody. It has no creed. It has no left or right. It's whatever's the hot topic. And I did some time in sociology in college, and you really have to kind of tap dance around these special issues in a certain kind of way. Now, it's her reply. She's sticking to her guns, and I get that. However, there's always another way.
Okay.
Always the path of least resistance, right?
Uh-huh.
Army style. So we got holidays coming up. Juneteenth, right?
Juneteenth.
Black Wall Street.
June 19th.
How good of a story would it have been to say, you know, hey, this is what happened. You know, on that horrible day, all of Black Wall Street got burnt down. But here in Clarksville, here we are. We're black. We're proud, you know. And all of the black businesses are now back, and they are booming.
Uh-huh.
And that's got a good spin, right? It's even got a certain holiday for it.
Okay.
Right? You know, and then you got what right now? Pride Month. Look. Boom, you can start saying, for Pride Month, we're going to do an LGBT special.
Understood. You know? So utilize the opportunity of holidays or calendar dates.
Yeah.
Yes,
that way
yes.
Everybody wins. Everybody's happy.
Good business promotion right there. I like that. So you don't have to have a tab that says black businesses only, right?
Right.
Because where do you stop after that? Do you know how many Asian-owned restaurants there are in Clarksville? And do you have to have a Spanish-only tab? I like your approach to it, Eric. That's a great solution to what people... Because here's some of the responses, by the way. Here, let's take a look at these. Here you go. All right, boom. The use of nationality, its ethnicity. I think you did a great job attempting to explain this issue. This is from Jai. Unfortunately, people like this won't understand. And Mary Richard goes, I agree with your assessment of local Clarksville, as in, you know, they need more diversity. Alyssa Lone Tree, okay, I'm so happy you spoke up. Going to unlike that page, now thank you for making me aware. And then Juanita, oh, I cut it off a little bit. Point out Hispanic, but I invited Juanita on the show. We got to get her on again soon. But then, okay, they are all well educated and the area and restaurants. They have featured a black restaurant, but as she stated, it's not their intention to do specifically to support the black community. Sorry to inform you, but lots of places operate that way. The response seems to make mention of having a relationship with the Hispanic community as if that's substituted a connection with the black community. Welcome to Clarksville. Plenty of places will have Clarksville in the name, but they do not welcome, support, or serve all Clarksville.
Well, that's clearly incorrect. That's not what she said.
That is, Lawyer Wayne, that is not what she said. Absolutely right.
So I'm misreading that.
Well, I mean, and that's the problem. That person just said, well, a lot of people don't understand. Well, that person obviously didn't understand or didn't read the message that was put out there.
Yeah.
Here, but here's where I get a little... So Ashley Baird then writes, hashtag apply pressure. Apply pressure. Ashley Baird, what do you mean apply pressure?
Yeah, that's that court of public opinion.
Okay.
Listen until you break.
Ashley Baird, I want you to come on the show. I would love to sit down and talk to you. Do I need to have a black section on my show, which is a promotion of businesses and events and highlights, stuff like that? Do I need to have a black person of the week? I say not. Hey, Casey Bryan of Local Clarksville. Tara, listen, you're not racist. Don't let these people bully you, okay? I invite them on the show. Let's talk. Let's have a discussion. Obviously, there's a misinterpretation of people's opinions here. And guess what? We're not going to figure it out behind the keyboard on Facebook, typing each other and going paragraph after paragraph after paragraph. In messages that are unspoken and not in person, misinterpretation is way too available. Come on the show. Let's talk about it all. We'll get Casey Bryan of Local Clarksville. We'll get whoever you want, Ashley Baird or these other people. Come on the show. You're more than welcome to. Anyone, believe you me, this is one of the most live. This is the most diverse show in this area by far. Not even close. No, look at all the guests and the lineup and the pictures. Forget about it. Man, Eric, it's a crazy world, man.
There's actually a formula for it, Joe.
Yeah, what's the formula?
All right.
Get close.
Let's
take
a
rock, all right? A normal rock.
Uh-huh.
If I were to point out this rock, I could use their formula to make rocks band. I could take the rock. I could take an incident back in time to where that rock was involved in the malicious act against a certain creed or origin. Rocks were used to stone women in the Middle East if they were disrespectful and not subservient to their husbands. Ergo, rocks are sexist, and all rocks should be banned.
What? What?
Hashtag ban rocks.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
He just went biblical, huh?
That's a good one.
Lawyer Wayne, you know the Bible.
They did use rocks.
Yeah, they did.
Dude, that was in Iraq when we were there, brother.
And how about this?
Still happening.
Yep.
He or she, without sin, cast that first stone. Unbelievable.
Boom.
Boom. I don't know nothing. I don't know nothing.
And plus, they're only one color in business, and that's green.
That's green, bae.
Good point, bae.
That's green.
True. You know, the suggestion that they could have a tab highlighting black businesses, okay, you know, you know, if there's a demand for that, you want to see it, fine. But then you're like, well, look, we're not in the business of separating businesses based on race and gender and such. We just want to highlight everybody equally. Okay, fine. I'm fine with a business pandering to the market.
Uh-huh.
Well,
but that's the word, pandering. You just said
you're like,
pandering.
Well, no, we're going to force you to do it this way. Well,
that's what I don't understand, the apply pressure.
But then I'm like, well, I ain't going to do it now just out of spite. You ain't going to make me do it.
Where were they before this is what my question is.
Shelly.
I'm not trying to stir the pot, but I'm just saying, if they were so adamant about this, where were they before this happened?
That's been the questions throughout the decade.
Thank you.
Wow. Man, hey, how opportune of you to say so at this moment, right? Where were you before?
Like a year ago.
Like a year ago, or two years ago.
They have a voice now, and I can understand that.
Okay.
Also.
Yeah.
You always have a voice. You just got to speak up.
Exactly.
And don't care what people think about you.
So maybe that's a good lesson to take away from all of this, is that we do have a voice, but we don't have to use it to hurt other people necessarily.
But a business, I believe, still has it. And Local Clarksville is a business, okay? But by the way, it's paid for advertising, okay?
Yeah.
On their site, all right? So, and they don't discriminate from any business.
Right.
Why green? Why bay? The color green.
Yeah, it's all about money, man.
I gotta pay bills.
You know, in our Bible study last week.
What's that, Lawyer Wayne?
When Paul is asked to circumcise his buddy.
Good boy.
And he won't do it in the one town because they're trying to make him do it.
Right.
But he does do it in the other town.
Right.
With his buddy, Timothy.
Timothy.
Yeah.
Isn't that something?
When you try to force me to do something, that makes me just not want to do it out of spite.
Right. Ladies and gentlemen.
That's nice.
Poor Timothy. That's a lot of friendship right there.
Lawyer Wayne turning this whole movement into a circumcision.
It's all about circumcision. That's what I'm saying. Hey, look it up.
To the tip of it all.
Act 17.
Just the tip.
No.
Joe.
Why are we?
Lawyer Wayne, can we do tips with the Lawyer Wayne?
Tips with Lawyer Wayne.
Every week. Once a week. Tips with the Lawyer Wayne.
There you go.
Snip.
Are we going to get around to pandering today?
Oh.
We should.
I got something.
Yeah?
I'm gonna pandering. I
just
do.
Pandering.
All right. Hold that thought.
I will.
Let's get ready for a quick break here, because I'll tell you what, I got to make money too. All right, I got Let's see. What do I got? I got a white-owned business commercial coming up. I got a white-owned business coming up. It's all right. Don't worry. Don't worry. It's diverse. What? All right. And don't forget, we also got footage. The body camera footage from what happened in Atlanta, Georgia, Friday night. And does it exonerate the police that got fired? We'll take a look. Hey, make sure to share your timeline. Leave those comments. Let's see what you're doing. Let me know what you think. We'll get to them. It's all happening next on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
Hey, this is Jeff Robinson, Black Horse Pub and Brewery, here at the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
So, one of the most stressful things to do is buy or sell a house. Well, that all changes. Why? Shelly Holiday Realtor Remax North Star. She eliminates the stress parts of buying or selling a house. She'll work that deal. She networks. She knows how to do it. She's Shelly Holiday, Realtor Remax North Star, and you want her. I'll tell you what. Just go to her Facebook page. She's Shelly Holiday, Realtor Remax North Star. Just do it. Click like, send her a message.
Welcome to Journey's Eye Studio of Clarksville, where one-of-a-kind vintage and modern furnishings are awaiting your arrival. Journey's Eye provides the special touches ideal for homeowners, businesses, realtors, and designers alike. The handcrafted Journey's Eye pieces are created in Clarksville, with unique items collected from around the world at affordable prices. Meet and greet Jody and Steve at 131 Franklin Street in historic downtown Clarksville, and visit online at journeyseyestudio.com. Journey's Eye Studio, enhancing your home and business surroundings.
Hello, Clarksville. Lawyer Wayne here. Did you know that the United States puts more of its citizens in jail and prison than any other country in the world? If you've been charged with a crime, don't become another statistic. Visit me at lawyerwayne.com. Learn about your rights, learn about your options. I offer free consultations. Come to my office downtown at 120 South 2nd Street. Let me see if I can help. Know your rights, know your options. Lawyerwayne.com.
Hi there, this is Hannah Price with Voice of Choice, and oh my God, I'm here with the best interviewer I've ever met. Joe Padula Show, absolutely.
The Joe Padula Show, absolutely. Intern Shane, you like this one? You like this music, Ben?
Yes, sir.
All right, he's not on camera, but he is in the room, Intern Shane. Intern Shane and I, we painted chairs all weekend at the lobby here at Office Now.
He's kind of young. Is he not allowed on camera because mom didn't sign the waiver?
No. He signed the paperwork. He's out of Austin P. And Eric, do me a favor. Say hello again. And what do you do for a living, Eric Torres?
How you doing? I protect the children. That's what I do.
Child services. Man, I bet you got some crazy stories.
Been doing it all my life, man, since I was a kid. I was right in and out of the system.
Right.
You know? But it's cool, though, because I'm like that one guy that gets in the place, and I get it from both sides.
Okay.
I'm stirring it up.
Yeah.
Because you know? I don't like the political panther, well, stuff.
Yeah.
And, you know, at the same time, I do believe sometimes we need to show up because who else is going to speak up for that kid?
There you go. I'm glad you're here today, my friend. It's been too long.
It has been.
I mean, we shut the show down for a little bit.
I was heartbroken.
Regrouped. And look at the new place, huh?
Yeah.
Office Now Studios. Check it out. If you got a business or something, you need to be 1861 Rudolph Boulevard. Prime location.
You know you got a stickball court in the back across that tree line?
I saw that. Stickball. By the way, this is not soda. This is water. This is sparkling water.
Okay.
Okay. Shelly goes, are you drinking soda?
Yeah, that was a bit
surprising. Says the girl that snorts Mountain Dew. Do you know what I mean? Don't judge me, Shelly. Where'd she go? Phone calls. All right. Lawyer Wayne on microphone.
Hello.
Bay.
How's it going?
And yes, Eric Torres, our friend from the Child Services.
Hey, jeez. I put that out there all the time, man. You know?
Yeah. Listen, I respect what you do. It's a tough gig. I couldn't do it. The crap that you must see.
Yeah.
The bad. But I bet there's also good that you see also.
Dude, there's awesomeness.
Okay, good. Share one of, later on today, share one of the good stories. All right, thank you. Yeah, appreciate that. Well, because we're going to end every show on a positive note.
I like positive.
Yep.
Absolutely positive.
I like positive, unless it's COVID positive. Then I don't like it. All right, well, unreal. The Atlanta Police Department. They released the officer body camera and dash cam. All the videos of the events leading up to the fatal shooting of Rayshard Brooks. This was Friday night. Everyone's heard the story so far.
Absolutely.
Bay, have you, Ryan?
A little bit.
Mm-hmm. Lawyer Wayne, do you know what's going on in Atlanta?
I don't think so. No.
Okay, I'm going to fill you in. Intern Chang, you know anything about this yet?
You told me about it yesterday.
Okay, actually. Never mind then. He's so honest. You're so honest. I love it.
Should have did your research, man. He told you about it yesterday. You got to look up.
I love it. Eric's hazing the intern. It's great.
I was there.
Right? All right, so the footage shows officers Garrett Rolfe and Devin Bronson speaking to Brooks for nearly 30 minutes on suspicion of DUI after apparently finding him asleep behind the wheel of his car in the drive-thru at Wendy's. Here, let's take a look at this video here. Let's see what we got. And definitely share it on your timeline. Put those comments in as you get them. They'll pop up on the screen. Here, let's take a quick look. If you don't mind. Boom, boom, boom.
No. No.
I'll tell you what, he was knocking pretty hard.
What's up, my man? Hey. What's my man?
Should have went to Waffle House.
You good? You don't need an ambulance or anything like that? Are you just tired? All right, man. Just... I'll move my car. Just pull up. Just pull somewhere and take it out. All right. 2805 green. I don't want to deal with this dude right now. How much did I drink tonight? Not much? How much is not much?
About a drink. Today.
All right. Hey, you have your license on you real quick?
Yep.
All right. Just relax the car. What are you, are you here for a visit or what's,
I'm visiting.
Where are you visiting?
My mother's grave site.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah.
How long has she, passed for?
It's been probably about a year and a half now, but.
Okay, I'm sorry to hear
my birthday's just passed and, my girlfriend's birthday just passed, but I went to visit her and
All right.
We decided to eat Burger King tonight and hey, this happened.
Right, I hear you.
I say, babe, what was scores?
Right. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna talk to this officer here for a minute and then we'll be good to go, okay?
Oh no problem.
All right, thank you, sir.
So this other officer that pulls up, this is a DUI cop. Do they have officers that are trained just to perform the sobriety test?
There are officers that are trained. I guess not. Not everybody would have that training.
I was under the assumption that all officers have had that training or are certified to do the sobriety test. What's up? Matt checking in. He goes, what's up, Joe Padula crew? Good to see you, brother. All right, let's continue watching the body cam footage and the dash cam footage from Friday night, Atlanta Police Department.
All right, stay in the car. Stay right there. Hey, what's going on?
What's going on?
So, found him passed out in the parking lot. He's sitting here.
So he was in the driveway?
Yeah, he's on, car's on. Took me like a few minutes to wake him up. Kept knocking, opened the door, but shook him. Woke up super groggy. Got a pretty good smell of alcohol beverage coming out of the car. Eyes are watery and glassy. Snorted his words. Wasn't sure where he was. And he's telling me he had one drink, he said, earlier.
Tell me, I wasn't here, so can you tell me what... what happened before we got here?
The drinks that were mentioned was in the audio. He said he only had one drink, a martini, earlier in the day. He later appears to tell the officers that he had a couple or one and a half drinks, saying that he had a daiquiri. So it was like as if he couldn't make up his mind on what drink he was drinking. But now here's the sobriety test.
I can just go home. I have my daughter's there right now. My daughter's birthday was yesterday.
All right. Hold on, Miss Brooks. Will you take a preliminary breath test for me? Just yes or no?
I don't want to refuse anything.
It's yes or no. It's completely up to you.
Yes, I will.
Lawyer Wayne, what happens when someone refuses a breathalyzer test?
Then the police have the option to, if they want, they can charge you with what's called implied consent.
Okay.
If it is found later that they did have a good reason to ask you for the breath test, and you refuse to take it, you can lose your license for up to a year.
Okay.
It's a civil violation, not a crime.
So either you do it or you don't, and if you don't...
The law has tried to create... They've tried to create the law in such a way, darned if you do, darned if you don't, put people in a trap where they have to decide, do I risk my license or do I risk the reliability of a breathalyzer that no one can really... You know.
Right. Mm-hmm. All right, let's continue.
Okay, just wait here while I grab.
What kind of drinks did you have?
All right, in case you can't see it, in Georgia, the legal limit is 0.08.
Okay, same as here.
In case you can't see the breathalyzer, it reads 0.108.
Okay.
Which is well above.
Two tenths of a percent higher than the legal limit.
Right.
I'm not sure. It's something she ordered. She said top shelf or whatever.
Top shelf what?
I'm not sure. It was, like I said, it was her birthday and...
You had about 1.5 drinks, but you don't remember what kind of drinks they were?
No, sir.
All right.
I really don't, Mr. Raw.
All right. I think you've had too much to drink to be driving, so put your hands behind your back for me. Here, put your hands behind your back.
Hey, stop! Warning. It's about to get a little graphic.
Did you see the taser? It wasn't secured.
On the officer.
Yeah, it, you know, that's...
Here, let's take a look.
Red flag one.
Let's take a look here. Da-da-da. The taser right there. Mm-hmm. It is flying around, huh? I don't know. How do they secure tasers? Do they have holsters for tasers also?
Yeah.
He's got the taser at this point.
He grabbed the other dude, too.
Yeah, the, right. Look at that. I mean, two officers, and this one guy is manhandling them, right?
There's a lot of people out there right now.
Stop fighting!
They're trying to say that it'd be best if they made it mandatory for all officers to take BJJ, just for situations like this.
To take what?
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
Yeah?
That's what they trained us with in the Army because the regular combative stuff didn't work. So we moved up to BJJ just so we can get control of the ground.
Yeah. Some type of martial art.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting, because these guys, they lost control. The guy resisted. The guy went, he wouldn't comply and resisted. They got him to the ground, as we saw, and stop resisting. We're going to tase you. We're going to tase you. He continues to resist, actually escapes some way, somehow, with one of the officer's tasers in his hand. Let's continue the video. Again, graphic, be careful. All right. They tase the guy. He's still running.
63.
They're finicky. Tasers are finicky.
Did you see that?
He shot back.
All right, so he's got the taser.
Right there.
He shot the taser back.
63.
And then the other officer shoots.
Look at that funnel right there. Look at that funnel. I mean, do you see that SUV parked right there?
Could you imagine being online at Wendy's and this is all happening?
I saw it happen on the side of the road driving towards here last year.
Unreal.
Guys are getting arrested. Takes a swing at the officers. They all went down.
Yeah.
53.
Did he hit the officer?
No, the cop got hit by the taser.
Yeah, did the cop get...
Can't tell.
Did the cop get tased?
I think he did because he ran into the car.
He ran into the car. In my head.
Well, no. I mean, have you ever been tased before, Joe?
Yeah, yeah.
You know how they have to have both connections, and 9 times out of 10, both those connections will never stick?
Yeah.
So, I mean, if you just have one pole hitting you, you might get a little bit, but you're not getting nothing.
When I got tased, I felt like a Barbie doll. My legs just locked in.
Yeah.
Right.
When it actually connects, you're in a perfect situation.
Uh-huh.
They're running right now,
yeah,
throwing that taser. So the chances of him actually hitting that officer correctly with that taser, next to none. I guarantee it.
All right. So then we saw the shots, two shots. According to the hospital, it was two shots in the back. Okay, two shots in the back.
So it sounded like one shot missed.
Yeah.
Sounded like he shot three.
Yeah, he did.
Okay, let's take a look. I heard three shots, right? The two hit, according to the hospital.
Dude, I hope there are no kids in that SUV.
Right?
Get shot three times. They're still telling me to stop fighting.
Come on, man.
They send him to the hospital. That's where he dies. Okay, he dies.
Did he hit you with it?
I felt it, but I don't. Oh, wait. If you're willing and able, I don't need anything specific at this juncture because I know you're still evaluating that. Just give me the pure basics of how we got up here.
Joe, you got the CPD.
I was called to do a DUI.
Clarksville Police Department, I believe, is on next week. Next week.
My investigation.
Okay, so his own three officers are on site.
Yeah. To develop probable cause to arrest the suspect for DUI. He resisted arrest and he gained control of the other officer's taser and started running. As I pursued him, he turned and started firing the taser at me.
Okay.
You're good, you alright?
Yeah. Still got the adrenaline pumping.
You alright?
No, I'm okay.
All right, good. All right, we're going to take care of you, bro. I'm just glad you are all right. That's my biggest concern.
Yeah, we're good.
All right, good. You talk to your wife, you talk to your family, everybody?
No, I hadn't called anybody other than the IPPO.
Okay. All right, hopefully we'll get this cleared up. Anything you need from me?
Any update on Mr. Brooks?
Well, I ain't checked yet, so.
Okay.
We'll get that squared away, all right?
All right.
Called him Mr. Brooks. Update on Mr. Brooks. No update at that moment.
But you're good.
You don't hear the media talking about the cop asking how the guy that he shot is doing. Yeah. All right, here, I got a little bit more of the video. Let's take a look. This is what happened the next day at Wendy's. The following day, protesters and what I call mobs did this to that Wendy's restaurant. They set fire to the Wendy's restaurant where Brooks was fatally shot that night before, and they also blocked off traffic on a nearby highway. The fire was set around 11:30 p.m., but video from the local news station showed it again, a flame around 4 a.m. Orlando police said that 36 people were arrested as of midnight. Wait, what did he just say?
He said the corporations don't care about the people's lives that matter. Life is more than that restaurant. Until they understand that.
Do you know the irony of that statement?
If they understand that we are worth more than these corporations, these buildings, our life matters, I'm afraid this is going to keep happening. We can't bring our people back, man. We're sick of this.
All right, before we get into this, okay, the burning, I got a question about the actual incident itself leading up to this. What would you have done? You're the officer. What would you have done? Eric?
I hate playing, you know, quarterback.
Yeah. Monday, right.
Yeah, but, I mean, I would have never made the shot. I couldn't have.
Right.
Because the first thing you see is that in your line of fire is an SUV. You know, all thoughts, you know, aside to Mr. Brooks or whatever, that SUV was in the, I couldn't pull the trigger.
What about shooting low? Why didn't they, why didn't he shoot low for a leg or a calf? You know what I mean?
Well,
is that part of the police training?
No. Nobody trains to shoot legs.
No?
Do you know you still have just as much chance of dying, you know, if you shot the leg? You know, the femoral arteries, you know.
That's a good horrible. Point. That's a good point, Ryan. So you don't shoot then?
You can't. And ROE, if that was me and you, and we were on that patrol, and we would have took that shot,
right?
We would have got hemmed up.
Yep, absolutely.
And they would have said it's failure on you to not have trained properly in order of taking down 2-1.
You know what I would have done? I would have waited in the guy's car. You got the guy's car there with everything in it. You got his wallet. You got everything, right?
He's drunk. His stamina is not going that far.
No. No. Let me tell you. The resisting of arrest. Don't do it. Don't do it, especially, I mean, hey, it's a DUI. You know, you're just going to brought the cuffs. I hear you. Bay, you see this. You saw the full footage now. Your thoughts.
But the thing is, when the dude that took off running shot the taser, sound like a little 22 going off.
Okay.
With all that action going on. Oh, he got a gun.
Could be. Could be. Even though I'm sure they did the pat downs and everything, you know.
But he took off running.
Yeah.
But you don't. It's a heated situation. You hear something sound like a gun go off.
And I hear you, because Eric, I mean, we've been there where it comes to the firefights. That adrenaline's running. It is pumping.
Countless kids getting shot holding cell phones.
It is survival. Shelly, I know you just came in, but have you seen the full footage?
I have.
Okay, your thoughts.
Which thought?
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
the cop, what should the cop have done, if not what he did?
That's so hard to say, because in that situation, I don't know that I wouldn't have done the same thing. I'm sure that there was a lot of adrenaline involved, like we were saying. And until you're in that situation, I don't think anybody knows what they would do.
Mm-hmm.
That's the truth.
Lawyer Wayne, you're a lawyer. What do you see here?
Man, I've never even been in a fight.
Yeah, I know.
Let alone a gunfight.
Uh-huh.
But you play video games.
I do. And with that experience, I would say, look, I don't know that I'd arm the police with the ordinary beat cops with guns. I wish they didn't carry guns at all, except that I know that the world's full of guns.
Right.
And if I don't arm them, all the bad guys are going to know, hey, these police ain't carrying any guns.
Mm-hmm.
The guy took a taser off of him, and then turns around and fires it while running.
And the cop staggers.
If the cop... Yeah, and that other guy...
Yeah,
the
his battle buddy...
Goes and crashes into the car. Look, if the guy said, look, I see him fire a weapon, it sounds... Because those tasers do pop when you fire... I saw a flash.
Yeah.
Sound like a 22.
If he says, look, I see him firing something at us, and I return fire. Yeah, I think... You know, certainly, you're right, the Monday morning quarterback, I got a nice wide-angle view of the entire thing, somebody cut together like a movie.
Mm-hmm.
No, it wasn't a gun, and the proper use of force ideally would be, if he's only firing a taser, you should only respond with non-lethal force as well. I think you're right that the environment, too, you know, with cars around. You're saying, you know, if I was sticking around, I wouldn't have taken that shot either, unless he genuinely thought this guy was firing a gun. Yeah, that's a tough one.
Yeah, and to be honest,
I want to be real hard on the cop for shooting, you know, killing a guy that didn't have a gun with a crowd. I'm sympathetic to people in emergency situations. I don't know what it feels like. You know, people talk about getting tunnel vision and things like that, acting out of instinct.
It happens. Like the word comply. Okay. You're about to get handcuffs on you, and you don't comply. Are you putting yourself even at a highest, like,
yes,
does he understand?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Or did he understand, or why do you think he didn't comply? Bang?
I have no idea.
Me neither.
108.
10, oh, okay, the breathalyzer. He didn't want to go to jail for the night.
I mean, that's not even very drunk.
You can't even think clearly.
A point.
0.108?
That's nothing.
It was 1.08, wasn't it?
No.
Point.
You'd be dead.
Point.
Oh,
okay.
Point one.
He's only a couple
Wayne,
of tenths of a percent
point,
above the legal limit.
He didn't. Lawyer Wayne.
Yeah.
Point 0.108.
Yeah. That's not very high.
Right.
Do,
Do we know his background? Do we know what his situation was? Do we know if he was in fear of going back to jail or not?
That's what I wanted to
know. I don't know the gentleman's backstory.
He went from zero to 100 there.
That's what I'm there.
Like,
everybody
real
was
quick.
Everybody was very polite. Everybody mm-hmm. was, you know, yes, yes, sir, no,
so there
sir,
had
yes,
to be a thought
sir.
Of, if they arrest me, I'm going back to jail.
And then all
maybe.
Of a sudden he went, I'm going to get out of this, and I'm going to try to take this taser out of this guy's hands, and I'm going to fire at it.
You're right, because the conversation was pretty cordial.
Yeah.
Leading up to all of this. You know, hey, my man. You know, and then even
I was looking to say, oh, these officers should have never bothered breathalyzing him. He, you know, he didn't look that drunk, you know, but then this happens. It's terrible.
Right. Yeah. Unreal.
Hey, Joe, can I say something?
Yeah. What do you got, Eric?
My problem with this whole thing is that, yes, a life is lost, but I feel that the way they're handling it, it's going to waste. When we have a bad problem, we have a plan of action. We have, you know, the three ups and three downs, and we implement that training to say, okay, how do we not make this happen again?
Uh-huh.
And, you know, they're talking about defunding instead of increasing the money to actually help train the police to not make these same mistakes and to live off of, you know, live from these mistakes.
You add more programs.
You add programs. You get the, you
Brazilian
know,
jiu-jitsu. I hear what you're saying.
BJJ, stress tests, stress shoots.
Absolutely.
I think that would have definitely helped in this.
Now, what about, like, and then we saw the Wendy's burn. What is that all about?
Dude, do you know how much Wendy's does for the community?
Why burn the Wendy's down? What was that gentleman's mentality?
They're the ones that started it.
How did they start it?
You heard the guy. The Wendy's is the one that called the cops out there. Same as that grocery store called the cops for the for George Floyd.
That's why
you burn down a business, is because it's the business that are in league with the police to start these incidents.
Well, then, should a business have a right to say who they want to serve and who they not want to serve?
They want, you know, the idea is that.
Why would
every
a business,
business
want to
owner,
serve someone that wants to burn them down?
Every business owner is going to think twice about calling the cops out to their place because they know what happens if they're going to get burned down.
We are going to see a huge spike in crime. Already seeing it. But I'm talking about for an entire, it could be 2 years. It could be like the 70s all over again in New York. Okay? The crime rate through the roof. Why? Who wants to be a cop right now? Who wants to be a cop? That Atlanta chief of police resigned. Here, take a look at this. Here, what the, this is what the mayor. This is what the mayor said following what's her name? Keisha Lance Bottoms. She's the mayor of Atlanta. So she called for the immediate firing of the officer who opened fire during that altercation at the Wendy's there. Here, let's take a look.
While there may be debate as to whether this was an appropriate use of deadly force, I firmly believe that there is a clear distinction between what you can do and what you should do. I do not believe that this was a justified use of deadly force and have called for the immediate termination of the officer. What has become abundantly clear over the last couple of weeks in Atlanta is that while we have a police force full of men and women who work alongside our communities with honor, respect, and dignity, there has been a disconnect with what our expectations are and should be as it relates to interactions with our officers and the communities in which they are entrusted to protect.
All right, so there you go. There's the mayor. Young mayor too, huh? So she called for the firing of officer Officer Rolfe was fired, by the way, and Officer Bronson, the other guy, he was placed on administrative duty. Now they're thinking about bringing up murder charges on this officer. Murder charges. Now, the resignation of the Atlanta police chief, Erica Shields, she's gone. The police chief.
Okay.
She resigned after this.
Now, do you know if it was a hashtag apply pressure resignation that was done?
Well, here's the thing, okay? Weeks ago, the media and journalists were praising this chief of police, okay? Here's who she looks like. Here, let's take a look at her here.
Instead of shooting, do a taser. I mean, they know when they pull a gun, 9 out of 10, they're going to kill somebody. If he's pointing a taser at a police officer, they have the bulletproof vest. A taser not going to hurt them if he shoot it in their chest. Just shoot them with a taser, not a gun. Every time something happens, you don't always have to pull a gun out on somebody. They have tasers for a reason.
That's what some of the folks down there are saying.
He took his taser.
Right.
Yeah, I'm thinking about this, you know, looking at it and thinking. I want to give the police a hard time on this one because you know, objectively, if you were to read through the rules, I'm sure that's too high an escalation of force. He's right with a guy with a taser. On the other hand, one guy, I can feel frustration on the part of the police department saying, if I see my buddy chasing down a guy that, you know, that we just had a ground fight with, he took my taser, don't, you know, he shoots him with something.
Well, the Georgia, you know, the GBI.
Just let it happen. Just sit back, you know.
Georgia Bureau of Investigation is conducting a full investigation as we speak. But here's the chief of police, now former chief of police for Atlanta PD.
And earlier today, Atlanta's police chief, you see her here, she also stepped down. GBI is investigating this police-involved shooting.
All right, so there's the chief of police, well, former chief of police now. So my question is, okay, because like I said, during the George Floyd protests in Atlanta, this chief of police was walking with the protesters side by side, arm in arm, and the media was like, oh, she's amazing. You see, this is how police chiefs should be. Now, this happened, now she steps down. Do you think she stepped down or resigned because she's fed up with whether or not the police officers can actually do their jobs? Or is it because she's white and she was asked to step down?
No.
Do you know who replaced her?
No.
A black man.
Well, I mean...
Right, because listen to this quote from the mayor. Atlanta Mayor Bottoms said this, quote, because of her desire that Atlanta be a model of what meaningful reform should look like across this country, Chief Shields has offered to immediately step aside as police chief so the city can move forward with urgency and rebuilding the trust so desperately needed throughout our communities.
So she's still on the payroll?
No, I think if she resigns, that's it, right? I mean, I'm sure she's getting a, like, is that a retirement? Did she get a retirement package? Because she's been on she's Atlanta PD for decades.
Oh, decades. Probably is eligible for retirement.
Man.
You know what I think they should really try to consider?
What's that, Eric?
Put that mayor in a stress chute.
Okay.
Know, the training, you know, just so that she can actually feel and understand. Because, I mean, me and Wayne, we sat here and we Monday morning quarterbacked the crap out of that situation.
Right.
Truth be told, though, none of us have ever actually been in a civilian, you know, police situation. I mean, yeah, I could sit here all day and say, well, you should have did more cardio, bro. You know, get your game up, step out there, sprint, tackle him down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But, again, I wasn't there.
Right. Right. Bay, what do you think, man?
He shouldn't have resisted.
Okay.
He shouldn't, because so many scenarios could have played out in that.
Yep, you're
because
right.
Because he was running towards a vehicle. He could have jumped in that vehicle, tried to take off.
I'm glad Shelly asked what she asked earlier.
There's so many scenarios, man.
There must have been something that triggered him.
It was his daughter's.
Jail. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You remember, he said it was his daughter's birthday.
Yeah, right.
And notice, everybody went quick to burn up the Wendy's. Not nobody went over there to give a donation to the daughter, who now has to probably, you know, raise herself without a dad.
That's true.
So.
Yeah, the families were out today, publicly speaking. I didn't get a chance to catch that footage. It happened right before we started. But yeah,
well, it's like what I was always told.
What's that, babe?
Don't resist.
You and me both.
Yeah. Right, for real.
Intern Shane, it's a crazy world out there. All right.
It truly is.
Yeah. Don't move out of your parents' house. All right. Live there forever.
Absolutely.
All right. Don't grow up. All right.
Yeah. Forget trying to get a place of my own.
Yes. Your parents are gonna love that I said that. All right.
No, they probably agree with you.
Okay, good.
I told my kid, wait till she's done with college.
I'll tell you what. Let's do something positive. Okay, let's positive time. You ready?
Oh.
Woo! Here's what we're gonna do. When we get back, okay? Everyone has got a story that made them smile or made them happy. Okay. All right. I'd like to hear that. I got mine. If you guys find yours, let us know. If you got any, send the links. Let's get to them. All right. Yes. Oh, happy day. It's coming up next on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
Hey, this is
Teresa Jarvis, mayor of Oak Grove. And Oak Grove loves Joe Padula. But Joe, come on now. Enough with the Cat West jokes. Absolutely.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. It's me, your tattoo. We used to do everything together. But now I feel like I don't even know you anymore. I haven't had sunscreen on me all summer, and I'm fading away here, but it's not too late. You can mend our relationship. Take me where we first met, to Noe Gretz, where we could get Sunbum sunscreen and Ohana tattoo butter and start showing me some love again. All I know is, if you don't take care of me, we are through, and I'm taking half of everything too. Noe Gretz, none whatsoever.
Water dogs, water dog scuba and safety. There's a whole world to discover underwater, and at Water Dog Scuba and Safety, they're here to help you explore it. Veteran and locally owned, and whether you're already an expert diver or beginner seeking adventure, Water Dogs offers private and scheduled dive trainings for all ages. Get those kids, but no dogs. Go check out their Facebook page. Look at their underwater videos. 681 North Spring Street, downtown Clarksville. Go say hello to Rich and Cecil and the team at Water Dog Scuba and Safety.
Hey, this is County Commissioner, District 8, Tangie Smith. And when I'm not saving the world or prancing down the halls of the White House, I'm listening to the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
La, 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 la. I'm going to put this out there. Whether you believe him, me or not, but man, we need more Jesus.
Amen.
We need more Jesus out there.
Amen.
Man, even if you don't believe in him, we need more Jesus. Well, there goes all the atheists.
It's all right. You said last Friday Ireland was here, so yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Shout out to the the Vineyard of Ireland.
You know, as we get ready to close out here for the day, so much negativity out there. Let's inject some positivity. Lawyer Wayne, what's something that you read or saw that made you smile today?
Saw a post on Clarksville chat.
Okay.
Somebody had, here it is, Clarksville chat, bragging on a local business, Stinky Pinky Trash Services.
Yes. Yes.
Did you see that one?
No. I love the Stinky Pinky trucks.
Basically, the complaint was the guy saw his trash bin, the little thing you roll out there.
Yeah.
And the wheels were off of it and set on top of the trash thing.
All right.
And he gets all mad, and he says he took a picture, was going to go complain about the business, and then he gets a call from him and says, hey, we saw the wheels that come off your thing, so we're going to be bringing a new one here. So
there you go.
It was just somebody who thought they were having a bad day.
Right.
And then turns out, no.
Listen, you guys are very quick on social media to complain.
His garbage folks were looking out for him.
Like, slow your roll.
And he took time out of his day to praise them for it.
Right. So. Keyboard nice. Commandos, take it easy.
What's the opposite of a Karen?
A Kyle.
No. Like a good Karen.
Oh, a good Karen?
Yeah, like local Clarksville always trying to promote
businesses
for the good things.
A Casey.
Yeah, be a Casey.
A Casey.
Find something nice to say about somebody.
Mm-hmm. Nice job, Lawyer Wayne. That's a good one.
Thank you.
Bae, what about you? What's something that you read or saw that made you smile today?
Into the Spider-Verse 2.
What?
Yeah, they're coming out with another movie.
What, do they have a trailer?
All right.
Not yet, no.
No? Mm-mm. Okay. Now, what is it?
Into the Spider-Verse.
What do you mean?
It's Spider-Man movie where it was animated.
Oh, yeah. Right, with the kid.
Yeah.
Right.
Miles Davis.
Yeah. So they're making a second. What was the first one about?
Introducing you into the Spider-Verse.
What's the Spider-Verse?
Multiple universes with different Spider-Men all colliding together. It's awesome.
So wait, is like the high school, like Peter Parker? Peter Parker's, right? That's Spider-Man?
Well, he's somewhat dead in that one.
Wait, is it Peter Parker or is it a different
Peter Parker?
Kid?
It's a different Spider-Man.
Uh-huh.
But Peter Parker dead in this.
Wait. Yeah. Then has their Spider-Man.
Miles Morales.
Spoiler alert.
Miles Morales.
In this universe, the kid Miles Morales becomes Spider-Man.
Yes.
Wait.
But then all the other universe Spider-Mans come in. He meets old Peter Parker and
Spider-Man Noir.
So Miles Morales got bit by a spider also?
Yeah, the same spider that bit Peter Parker.
Took him a while. At the same time or years time. Later?
Like years later.
Yeah. Where's this biter been living?
And it's still alive?
Yeah. Man, spider's got a long life.
It was a different spider.
No, it was the same one.
Okay.
All right. So Bay's, that made Bay smile today. All right. Eric, what's a good story that made you smile?
I'm going to take a chapter out of my life, and I'm going to condense it to about 5 minutes maybe.
Okay.
All right. So 12 years old, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay. So I am the son of a young lord, my mother. That's like the Latin version of it's the Latin chapter of the Black Panthers.
And okay.
My dad was a Latin king. That fell after, you know, they injected cocaine into, you know, financially stabilizing the revolution.
Oh.
Either way, so 24 different foster homes, yeah, me and my brothers, group homes and all that stuff.
Uh-huh.
At 12 years old, I got it into my head. I was at East Ohio Boys Town. I got it into my head. I'm going home. I'm done with this. I'm tired of being in the system. So I, you know, maybe another day on the show, I'll tell you the whole story, but I got a plan. I cooked it up, and I made it from Cleveland, Ohio to Reading, Pennsylvania, well, by myself.
Well, how old were you at this point?
12.
Okay, so 12 years old. You come up with a plot to escape the foster home.
It was a group home. Yeah, East 99
so,
in St. Clair.
So it was like
place.
So it was like Little Orphan Annie setting where there was a bunch of you kids in there?
Dude, I was like the littlest runt there. I used to get my head kicked in on a daily.
Did they have security there?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Guys with guns and everything.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How'd you sneak out?
I'll tell you on the show another day, you know, when we have time.
Was it like with ropes out of the window or blankets?
No, dude, it was most group homes, like especially around here, they're old, they're like houses, right?
Uh-huh.
They look like legit, really huge houses. They're just fenced off and stuff like that.
Did you have to hop a fence?
No.
Did you dig a tunnel like Shawshank Redemption?
Dude, I made it better. I Machiavelli'd a plan to get one of the guys to hold the door open for me.
Okay, hold that story. We'll tease that. We'll do another one. Okay, so anyway, so you're out.
So
12 years old.
Yeah.
Little Eric.
Yeah, freaking...
Did you have a nickname? Did you have a...
In the home?
Yeah.
Dude, they called me everything under the sun, but nothing I can make on a family-friendly show.
Okay, gotcha.
All right.
Yeah, bad name.
But I think the main name that stuck with me was Gizmo.
Gizmo?
Yeah.
Oh, because of...
the Gremlins, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, because you're a little guy at the time, right?
Yeah, my sister gave it to me when I was born.
Right,
but,
because if you feed him after midnight, he multiplies. You got to be careful, right?
Yeah,
don't get him wet.
Hey, here's a twist. My first kid was at 15. But
oh my God! Like I said, don't get them wet. All right.
But anyway, I made it all the way to Reading, Pennsylvania, and that's a whole other story. I mean, it's a freaking great story. Everybody loves it. But that's another time. Cigar, whiskey, or something.
Yeah.
But my caseworker finally found out where I was at. Now you know we're all supposed to be bureaucratic in the child protection system. We're supposed to follow all the rules.
Okay.
This guy turns a blind eye to me. You know, he says, "Look, dude, if you stay out of trouble for 30 days, I'm closing the case. I got nothing." I get arrested that night, but we put that under the rug, too.
Oh,
so he
no.
gave me another chance.
What did you get arrested for? Do you remember?
I didn't know curfew was a thing.
Oh, okay. You violated curfew.
I didn't know it was a thing. I was just out tagging, and I got pulled over for curfew.
Tagging?
Yeah.
Spray painting?
Yeah. But
yeah, I found out about curfew when we were playing Manhunt.
In Tennessee,
one night.
It's 11 o'clock, kiddos. Yeah.
Is it really?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
What age? Is 16 and below?
It's on the weekdays.
Craziest part?
Wow.
I still talk to the guy today.
Who, the guy that let you go?
Shouts out to Daniel Hartman, yes. He's my mentor through this whole job. Every time I get a hard time, him and another social worker I had, Chris Ferry, I'll call him up and I'll say, dude, I'm done.
Uh-huh.
And then they'll just walk me through it, you know. And Dan is crazy because I gave him a headache. I gave him the headache from hell. You know, me and my brothers did 24 different foster homes. We were like the worst case he ever had.
Right.
Like, closing our case, he retired. Boom, he was done.
Mm-hmm.
And, but he still talks to me today. He wrote me a letter, you know, the other day saying he was proud that I actually beat the odds, beat the system, came around, and actually made something of myself.
That's what's up.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
I mean, if I could do it, anybody could do it.
And now look at you. You're making a difference for these kids.
Yeah. I try to inject it every day. I look at them.
Good deal. I'll tell you what. Yeah, let's pick a day. Now I got tons of questions.
Yeah. Ask your audience. You got
tons of questions.
Yeah.
We'll pick a day. We'll do it. Was there girls in there, too, in the foster home?
No, dude, they were, like, all the way on the other side of town.
Did you guys sneak? Why didn't you sneak over there?
No, there was the neighborhood girl that was, like, across the street over the fence. And she had a boyfriend-girlfriend thing, and I actually Machiavelli'd that into my plan, too, you know?
Yeah.
So I used that.
Do you still keep in touch with her, too?
No. I didn't really talk
to
her.
Here, I'll find her on Facebook. What's her name?
Dude, I don't even know. I wasn't allowed to talk to her because I was the runt.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but, you know.
You were Gizmo.
Yeah,
she wanted Spike. Right.
T-Bird, actually. I think that was his name.
Oh, T-Bird.
That's crazy.
We will tell your story, though.
Wow.
Nice job. That does make me smile listening to that. Shelly, good luck topping that.
I know. I was going to tell you about a dog who gives blood to save other dogs' lives, but that just doesn't even seem like it's relevant.
Woof. All right. That sounds
nice. I really want you to come back and tell your whole story. It sounds exciting and interesting.
And we'll have that dog in the studio that gives blood.
Please do. Please do. I love pork porks. And July 16th is my birthday, Joe.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. Maybe we'll do it on your birthday.
That'd be cool.
Okay? What day is the 16th?
I don't know.
It's your birthday.
I got no freaking clue.
All right.
The only way I know it's my birthday is my kids make fun of me for being another year older and they give me stuff.
Well, you look young, so that's good. The 16th. That's
Thursday.
That's July 16th? July. Or June 16th?
July.
Oh, yeah. June 16th tomorrow.
Yeah.
We got Mayor Durrett on the show tomorrow. Guess who else is making a comeback tomorrow?
Who?
Sky.
Hey.
The lovely Sky. Mm. Intern Shane, ever meet Sky?
I don't think I have.
Oh.
Yeah, she reminds me. Whatever happened to Tattoo Betty? She still come on?
She was supposed to come on today.
I missed Tattoo
She blew
Betty.
Us off.
She was on a few weeks
yeah,
ago.
Yeah. She was in a test show. All right. When the cameras weren't really that good. But now they're better. Yeah. Now Shelly's got red hair on the camera.
I know. What's that about?
The 16th of July. Let's see. You are going to be booked.
Thursday.
It's a Thursday. It's a court day, so yeah, I should be all right.
Oh, and we'll do conspiracy theory Thursday, too.
Ooh, conspiracy theory Thursday.
Here's what made me smile today. Here's a story that I just had a nice eating grin on my face. 1,000-sign petition to replace Tennessee Confederate statues with Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton.
Big statues.
That'd be a nice burst.
Everywhere. Oh, my God. That's a lot of concrete.
That's another conversation. Dude. Right. I got to stop.
A whole new meaning to over-the-shoulder boulder holder. Right. Yep. Unbelievable. So we'll see what happens with that.
She's done a lot for Tennessee. I'll give it
that. Oh, absolutely. I mean, it's a weird one because I'm not all for tearing down these statues and erasing history.
It's a slippery slope.
But, like, have her in all the poses, like riding the horse, holding the sword.
Yes.
It's exactly the same statue, except it's just her in it.
You add her to the existing statue.
Oh, just add it.
Right. Dolly makes everything better.
She does.
Right.
Put a statue of her next to Mom.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Bring Ernest P. World back, too.
Hey,
dude.
Robert E. Lee.
He's from Tennessee.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Know what I mean, Vern?
Yeah.
Right.
No, man.
He's from Tennessee.
Jim Varn. He died way too early.
Yeah, are you suggesting that Dolly Parton has never done anything or said anything racist in her past?
No, she said something sexist. That whole 9 to 5 movie.
Okay.
Yeah. That was sexist towards men.
No, dude, you give it a week. Surely somebody on Facebook is going to try to find it and try to twist it.
I don't think we can have a statue.
I would love
of anyone,
to try and twist
actually.
It.
Stop. Please stop.
Family friendly.
Well, here's my question. Here in Clarksville, we got the Confederate soldier memorial bridge. When are they going to start demanding that being taken down?
Or the bridge?
Probably now.
This is where it starts.
Right.
And soon it's going to go probably to religion. Or what about the Union? You know, more Natives were accepted in the Confederate Army than they were in the Union Army. Mm-hmm. The Confederate Army even had Native American generals.
Huh.
So what's going to happen when somebody figures this out and tries to get rid of the Union statues?
Right.
And then after that, it's going to be all Army statues?
Christopher Columbus? How about this? How about the Statue of David? The historic David statue.
He slayed thousands.
Right?
Yeah.
Right? Mass murderer.
Let's
King David.
Too.
Yeah. 200 Philistines at once.
Right.
And he also circumcised them after they were dead. So there you go. That's another one.
That's kind
of
sick.
Lawyer Wayne's tip of the week.
200 of them.
Oh, unbelievable. Oh, happy day.
Well, they were smaller than scalps.
All right. We got to get ready to get out of here. But I tell you, it's not easy topics.
No.
These are not easy times. Intern Shane, how old are you?
22.
I don't envy you at this time. Last year, I would have been like, oh, you're 22. Oh, my God, all the Tinder dates. But no, this is a tough time. You got to keep a cool head, though. Take it easy. All right? I see you guys on social media. You want instant satisfaction and relief. And I don't think you're going about it the right way. Conversation, discussion, cordialness, even if you don't agree. I don't agree with Lawyer Wayne all the time. I don't agree with Bay all the time. Definitely don't agree with Shelly at all. Eric, I think you and I see more eye to eye than most.
It's a bad thing.
But hey, here's the thing. We sit down, we talk about it. I mean, we discuss it. I don't send Shelly
rage messages.
Cancel her!
No. No.
He says, Shelly, what do you mean?
Yeah. Yeah. What are you talking about? And hey, if you don't agree with us, come on the show. We'll ask you, what are you talking about? And then we'll go get drinks afterwards. That's what we're missing.
Please don't burn the building down.
Listen, I may not agree with you, but I love you. And I love this city. Don't ruin this city, all right? We're a beacon of hope here. Clarksville, proud of you.
Always.
We'll see you tomorrow with the mayor and Sky on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely.
Hey, you. Yeah, you. It's me, your tattoo. We used to do everything together, but now I feel like I don't even know you anymore. I haven't had sunscreen on me all summer, and I'm fading away here, but it's not too late. You can mend our relationship. Take me where we first met, to No Egrets, where we could get Sunbum sunscreen and Ohana tattoo butter and start showing me some love again. All I know is, if you don't take care of me, we are through. And I'm taking half of everything, too. No Egrets. None whatsoever.
Joe Padula here. I see you watching the video. Do you want to be in the video? Come join us in the studio. All you gotta do is go to the Joe Padula Show Facebook page, click like, send a private message. It's too easy. Absolutely. You know what I can't stand? When you have people in Clarksville saying that there is nothing to do. Not for nothing, you couldn't be any more wrong. And obviously, you've never been to O'Connor's Irish Pub. Right off of exit 1. It's like an adult daycare center. I mean, you go inside, you got the food, you got the drinks, okay? You got the DJ, you got the stage, you got the live music, the whole bit. It's fantastic. They got pool tables in the back, dartboards, video games, UFC main events on the dozens of screens that are inside and out. Oh, and outside, they got the cornhole boards, they got the outdoor tiki bar, they got the outdoor DJ party, they got this huge, massive stage where they bring in the big names like Black Label Society and Puddle of Mud and Greta Van Fleet. The monthly bikini contests are great, and I'm even getting good at that beer pong. They got karaoke nights on Wednesday, open 7 days a week. There's always something to do in Clarksville, O'Connor's Irish Pub, exit 1. Absolutely.
Water dogs. Water dog scuba and safety. There's a whole world to discover underwater, and at Water Dog Scuba and Safety, they're here to help you explore it. Veteran and locally owned, and whether you're already an expert diver or a beginner seeking adventure, Water Dogs offers private and scheduled dive trainings for all ages. Get those kids, but no dogs. Go check out their Facebook page. Look at their underwater videos. 681 North Spring Street, downtown Clarksville. Go say hello to Rich and Cecil and the team at Water Dog Scuba and Safety.
Hey, y'all. This is Shelly Holiday, realtor at RE/MAX North Star. So feel free to add your comments and don't forget to share it on your timeline. Bay's my